This is a production of PBS 39.
If you're a gardener or just a harvester of fascinating did you know type facts, you'll want to check out Grover Silcox's visit with Mike McGrath, the guru of organic gardening, the host of NPR's You Bet Your Garden, and a resident of the Lehigh Valley. In this next segment, you'll find tricks for growing tomatoes, a tricky way to use bugs to get rid of bugs, and lots more. So sit back and get ready for a bumper crop of great gardening advice.
He's the master of mulch, the king of compost, but mostly, he's the host of National Public Radio's You Bet Your Garden. He's Mike McGrath, tipster for beginner or even seasoned organic gardeners. So what's Mike's tip for getting started?
Start small. If you don't have a garden, don't grow in flat ground. That's for suckers. You want to get your raised beds like 6 inches to a foot away from the surrounding soil. Build it up. Frame it if you want. Improving the soil is job number one. Build up the organic matter content in your soil. And not only will your plants have all the food they need, they're not attractive to pests. They're not attractive to disease.
Mike prepared his beds by eliminating clay and stones, using rich compost, and mulching.
This is homemade compost. It's not stuff that's been screened or, you know, bagged up by professionals. So it's going to have a couple of, like, little pieces of leaves in it. And it's going to have, like, maybe a couple of small stones like this that you toss out. But it's also got a ton of natural nutrition.
Once you prepare the garden, do you buy plants or seeds?
The first year in the garden, buy all your plants. Put your energy into really creating a couple of very high quality raised beds. And I mean a couple. Because once these raised beds are created, you're never going to step into them again. You're never going to compress the soil.
Today, Mike's adding another tomato plant to his garden.
But when you plant your tomatoes, you want to bury them deeply.
Now here's a trick for growing healthy tomatoes.
When they have adequate calcium at the root level, they can manipulate their water needs brilliantly. It's like you put the crushed shells of a dozen eggs in each planting hole, and you'll never see blossom end rot.
Okay, the tomato's neatly planted. Now what?
You want to mulch with compost. Now, this is going to keep weeds down just as well as shredded leaves, but the living compost is going to make the surface of the soil almost impossible for disease organisms to take hold.
Now that you've planted your tomatoes with care, it's time to give them structure.
And a lot of people it's a disaster because they just put it in the ground and they don't realize the tomatoes are vine.
Mike finds caging works best to keep his tomato plant posture perfect. For a tomato plant, that is.
You know, it may be standing straight up now, but sooner or later it's going to revert to its natural heritage and start sprawling all over.
You've made your tomato plant's bed, but it can still attract strange bedfellows, the kind that like to eat tomatoes. A flowering tickweed offers a solution.
Every one of those little splotches of yellow color is an individual flower. So tiny, we can barely make out the distinctions between them, but perfect for a wasp. That is so small, it's the size of the period at the end of a sentence in a newspaper, to come in and get a little sugar rush, then come over here and lay its eggs inside the tomato hornworm that is trying to eat my tomato plant.
Here's another good natural pest control technique.
You'll notice the bird bath is in the very center of the garden. That's free pest control. So when they come in for the water, they're prowling my plants for caterpillars and leafhoppers and aphids.
While pests are discouraged from entering the garden, certain reporters are welcomed in to try something new, such as garlic scapes.
That is one of the most rewarding and easiest things to grow. And if you have any Italian blood at all, you're kind of DNA obligated to grow a crop of garlic at some point in your life.
Hard to believe, garlic bulbs planted in the fall blossom into curlicues called scapes. Just cut and pick them to grow bigger bulbs. But don't throw them away. Scapes have a mild garlic flavor and taste great cooked in Spanish olive oil and some of Mike's homemade garlic vinegar. Of course, if you're not up for garlic scapes, you can always chow down on pansies.
Anyone with varicose or spider veins will want to pay close attention to the pansy.
These guys are not only edible, but they're a good source of rutin, which builds up capillary walls for heart and vascular health.
Is there anything prettier than a pint of these?
Pretty, yes, but not as powerful as the call of the sizzling garlic scapes. why it's enough to make a seasoned reporter yearn to become a budding organic gardener. For Tempo, I'm Grover Silcox, reporting.